Hello, I'm Ron Steffig, the Supervisor of Reservoir Engineering for the British Columbia Oil and Gas Commission. I'll be providing narration on the slides for produced water disposal wells and injection wells. Closed captioning is available for this presentation, and any questions you may have can be addressed to stakeholder@bcogc.ca, the address that appears on the screen. This presentation will include information on water injection wells and water disposal wells, what the difference is between the two, a brief slide on the oil and gas water cycle handling of water, the application and approval process for a disposal well, and finally some information on performance and compliance monitoring of those wells. First topic up is water injection wells, also known as water flooding, where water is injected into the deep subsurface to the depths of the oil pools. Water injected is then produced out of the production wells, flowing to the surface. The oil and water are then separated, oil being sold naturally and the water being re-injected into the pool to maintain that cycle. So the water is going around and around several times to maintain that production level. Oil and water don't mix, as we know, so the water going in there pushes the oil towards those production wells. It also keeps the reservoir pressure high, which has benefits towards production. There are currently 269 active water injection wells in the province. A bit of a primer on water flood projects. Primary production typically recovers only 20% of the oil in a pool. By applying water flood technology, we can typically double that recovery to approximately 40%. Of the oil, so a strong economic driver for that type of project. 91 water flood projects have been approved in British Columbia, of which 40 are still in operation. The largest water flood pools involve hundreds of injection and production wells, and a project may operate for a lifespan of anywhere from 10 to 60 plus years, depending on a number of factors about the pool. Typically, the larger pools will have a longer lifespan. Here's a map view of one of the largest water flood projects in the province of British Columbia. In this case, we're showing the green dots are the oil production wells and the blue being the water injection wells. So those are actually drilled and operated in a specific pattern to maximize the oil recovery. This diagram illustrates the complex oil and gas water cycle, water which is used in oil and gas production operations. The gray shows areas where we're using salt water or saline water, which is produced from the deep subsurface, and the blue being fresh or usable water. I'll not be going through this in great detail, but just the diagram shows the complex nature of interactions and use of water, which is highly regulated to ensure environmental protection in all phases of operation. We'll now be talking about water disposal and water disposal wells. Unlike water floods, in the case of disposal, the intention for the injection is for the water to remain forever in the deep subsurface. We are targeting deep water saturated formations that already have saline water within them or depleted oil and gas pools. The pool pressure increases over time as we're disposing into those and has to be monitored. In a few cases, though, I'll mention that companies are actually targeting these water disposal aquifer systems to produce that water back out and use that as a subsurface storage to use salt water in place of fresh water for operations such as hydraulic fracturing. There are currently 81 active water disposal wells in the province. The sources of the disposal fluid going into disposal wells is primarily produced water. That is defined as two separate items, first being the ancient water, which is coming out of the formations with oil and gas. So anytime you are producing an oil and gas well, there is a certain amount of water associated with that, which is separated at the surface, and by law has to be re-injected into disposal wells. We also have hydraulic fracture flowback water. After hydraulic fracturing, when the well is brought on production, a large amount of that water flows back up to the surface and ultimately will be placed into disposal wells. We also have disposal of something called non-hazardous wastes. Those are examples of things like tank wash, drilling waste, leachates, and other types of non-hazardous fluids associated with oil and gas operations, which may have an oil sheen associated with them, other properties that require them to be disposed into the deep subsurface. The Commission maintains records of the amount of water produced from wells as well as injected into disposal wells, also the chemical makeup of that water through electronic database of over 10,000 produced water analysis. That includes the analysis of hydraulic fracture flowback water. That is a requirement under our Drilling and Production Regulation, Section 71, that all wells must be sampled, and also the analysis must be performed and submitted to the Commission within 60 days. Disposal wells are typically over 1,000 meters in depth, targeting saline aquifers or depleted oil and gas pools, as previously mentioned. Those pools are isolated from usable groundwater or the surface through multiple impermeable barriers of shales. The well construction, looking at the diagram to the upper left-hand corner, involves multiple casing strings that are cemented and tubing within the well itself, all arranged in a manner to isolate the disposal fluid from any potential contact with other formations. Looking at the more detailed diagram, which is a requirement to be submitted to the Commission with all the mechanical information within there, we show that there is the tubing within the well, the yellow being an arrangement called packer systems, which again prevent any water from flowing from the deep subsurface up and contact the shallower casing to cause any corrosion or integrity problems. This map illustrates the location of all active disposal wells in Northeast British Columbia. As I mentioned, there's approximately 81 wells that are operating in any 1 month. The larger the circle around the well indicates a larger cumulative volume which has gone into that location. Water at those disposal wells is brought there either by pipeline systems where they're connected to the production facilities, or may be hauled there by tanker trucks or both methods to deliver those fluids. We will now look at the application process to use a well for disposal service. The company may either drill a new well with a well permit which has been issued for the purpose of disposal use, or they may repurpose an existing well with an amendment to the well permit. A disposal well may be operated by an oil and gas production company or by a disposal service provider, companies which specialize in the handling of oil and gas field waste. There's a rigorous application process which must be submitted to the Commission, and the Commission has a team which does reviews on these applications which cover a wide variety of facets, such as the hydrogeology, petroleum geology, drilling, a look at any potential for induced seismicity, as well as reservoir engineering. Following that review, if the well is approved for disposal use, appropriate conditions are applied. The Commission provides a detailed application guide to industry with the numerous requirements for use of a well for disposal, basically going through a checklist. As illustrated, the application guide is very detailed, being 4 pages long. Upon review of an application, an approval may be granted by the Commission, containing a number of detailed conditions for the operation reporting on that well, or the application may be denied in some cases because of risks that have been identified during the review process. The Oil and Gas Commission website contains an approvals library for all subsurface reservoir projects, which include disposal wells, the address noted at the lower left-hand corner of this slide. We do have a search function built into that actual location where you can search by a well name, a company, a field location, etc. This slide illustrates a typical cover letter to an approval which has been sent out to a company for disposal use of a well. Disposal use is approved under Section 75 of the Oil and Gas Activities Act as a special project order. The cover letter itself contains some background on the well itself and also highlights any conditions within the approval which should be noted by the company. Shown here is an example of a disposal approval. which is granted under Section 75 as mentioned. The actual order itself contains numerous conditions for measurement, monitoring, and verification of operation of the well. The orders typically also contain something called an advisory guidance, which lists a number of requirements under regulations, just to reiterate those to the company and make sure they are aware and can comply with those requirements. Disposal wells and related facilities are subject to regular field inspections by commission staff to ensure they're conforming to all regulatory requirements. Disposal wells are also subject to regular desktop inspections or audits by our engineers to ensure compliance with all operating, testing, monitoring, and reporting requirements, typically looking at the monthly volume and injection pressure reporting to ensure that those pressures are staying below the maximum limit which has been allowed. Also, annual reservoir pressure test is required to confirm that the storage pressure remains below the maximum permissible limit. Something called an annual packer isolation test confirms the integrity of the production packer and casing in the well. And also there's a requirement every few years for special survey tools to be run downhole in the wells to confirm the integrity of the casing, as well as the depth of the fluid which is being injected to confirm that that is staying within the zone which is permitted. In February of 2022, the Commission launched the Disposal Well Dashboard on our website, which provides comprehensive information about disposal wells and their operations. The Commission is the first jurisdiction to publish information in this format and has been well received by all stakeholders. Industry has now been using this tool as a manner of identifying appropriate locations for disposal wells. This slide contains a screenshot of the disposal well dashboard. In the center of the screen, there is some basic information about the well and the approval itself. The other charts and graphs show the performance of the well over time. One of the key items on here is showing the monthly disposal pressure and volume of the well, and confirms that the disposal pressure is staying below the maximum value, the red line on that graph. Looking at the upper right-hand corner, we have a graph which shows the annual reservoir pressure compared to time and volume. With that information, we can project forward what the ultimate capacity of disposal will be at that particular location before it reaches that maximum storage pressure. So looking at this type of information, it's possible for industry to compare their wells with other offsetting wells or get an idea about which formations and which areas may be the most prospective for further disposal operation, as well as providing the Commission a snapshot method of ensuring compliance is occurring with that well. That concludes our presentation. I hope you found that to be somewhat helpful for better understanding water injection and water disposal in oil and gas operations. As mentioned previously, any questions can be submitted to stakeholder@bcogc.ca. And I thank you for your time.